We have a very lovely special guest. And I will be asking Vandy if you have... Oh, okay. She's going to start.
You're live. Now.
Yeah.
You're live. You can go right ahead, Kai.
Okay. So we are live on... we're recorded, right? We're recording and live. Yes, definitely. YouTube. Thank you, Vandy. So... I believe we are, it's 8 o'clock, and so we are going to get started, okay? Well, what an amazing Wednesday evening for all of us tonight, you guys. We welcome you all at our Think Like a Pro Leadership Training Call, brought to you by, of course, four elite crossline leaders led by Dr. Jean DeLucia from Tampa, Florida, Debbie Kral from Ocala, Florida, Vandy Flay from Snowflake, Arizona, and yours truly, Kai Hayes from Austin, Texas. Well, 6 months ago, we formed an alliance to help you, yes, you, aspiring and committed distributors, reach your goals to become our future elites. That's right. So these Zoom meetings are for you guys. So make sure that you are constantly plugging in with us every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock Central Time. Otherwise, without you guys, we don't have this Zoom call, okay? And for those of you who were orphaned by their sponsors, of course, we welcome you. At Think Like a Pro, we practice diversity and inclusion. And the four of us are here to welcome and serve you all and encourage you to learn and duplicate our system. So take good notes. And whatever you learn, you must take it into action. Because knowledge without action leads to quitting, right? And why? Because you will get frustrated. And when you are frustrated, you do not want to do anything, right? So don't make excuses when your upline tells you that training and events are non-negotiable. We mean it. We mean it, okay? So just to remind you all that last month of March, we announced a couple of rank advancements as well as bonus pool achievers. That was really cool, you guys. So this month of April, we are expecting more rank advancements and bonus pool achievers. Guys, it is doable. So go get it and get that extra cash in your pockets. Again, no excuses. Because tonight, we bring you one of the best trainers.
Kai, you're muted.
Sorry, I accidentally pressed it. I was saying, tonight we bring you one of the best trainers to inspire you, not only to win the bonus pool points, right? But how to create an elite rank in 4 years. Wow. We are so fortunate to have our newest Elite Pro 8, Angie Harper, out of California tonight. Angie is married to Garrett and blessed with two wonderful boys, Ryan and Nick. And you would not believe this, but Angie said no to Tara Wilson in 2007. Yes. However, you know, health issues led her to take our products, and of course, the rest is history, you guys. By the way, I was also with Angie and our common friend, good friend, Christy Vaught in Ireland incentive trip. And guys, we had so much fun out there. And I really love this girl so much because she always wears that beautiful smile on her face. And I'm just so happy for her success. And so excited tonight because number one, we shall hear her remarkable story, you guys. Number two, she will walk us through how events, trainings, and having that accountability partner or partners helped her achieve her Pro 8 status. And the third, she will provide us with pieces of advice for those who wants to quit. And number four, she will tell us if anyone can achieve elite rank while doing this part-time, because I hear you guys over and over. Can you do this part-time? Can you do this part-time? Of course you can. So without further ado, let me take you to our special guest, Angie Harper. Take it away, my friend.
Kai, thank you so much for that introduction. Awesome. I have to say, think like a pro. I'm like, man, am I a pro? Is that what I am? I'll try to do my best here, you guys, tonight. And I see a lot of my team out there. Thank you guys so much for hopping on and supporting me. And I love that you guys do this cross-lane training. I think it's phenomenal. So thank you for asking me to be a part of it. And I will do my best to share my story and inspire those of you out there, especially the new people who are thinking to themselves, what the heck did I get myself into, right? So I'm going to share my story, which started my journey with this company started in 2016. And it started while I was browsing Facebook one day, and I saw the beautiful face of Tara Wilson pop up, and she was doing a Facebook Live. And it was way at the beginning when Facebook Lives first began. And I didn't know at the time that when you clicked on it, your name popped up. So here I thought I was being sneaky, and I'm like, what's Tara up to now? And sure enough, my name popped up, and she messaged me, nothing about the business or the products, just hello, great to see you. How are you doing? And, you know, Tara and I had actually, you know, we've been friends since we were teenagers, 16 and 17, but we've kind of fallen out of touch for a number of years until 2016 when I saw that Facebook Live. And gosh, 10 years prior to that, I was a kindergarten teacher. I taught for 10 years and Tara was in mortgages. And it was the time she was leaving mortgages to join a network marketing company. She called me really excited. And she said, Angie, I've got this amazing opportunity, this amazing product. It was an acai juice. And she said, I want you to be a part of it. Now, I really didn't have experience in network marketing. I did sell Cookie Lee jewelry for a minute, but I really didn't even know it was network marketing. I was selling jewelry because I loved it. I didn't know I was supposed to like ask people to sell under me. And so she was like, I think you'd be great at this. And I was really excited. I went home and I told my husband, Garrett, I said, Tara has this awesome opportunity. I think I want to do it. And Garrett looked at me and said, is that network marketing? Is it one of those pyramid schemes where you make money off your friends and family? And I thought, oh my gosh, yeah, I think it is. And he said, tell her we're not interested. And so I did, you guys. I emailed her and I said, I'm sorry, but we're not interested. I emailed her. And so it kind of, you know, I wouldn't say created a rift, but she went on to do and to become Tara Wilson, right? We all know Tara Wilson, Elite Pro 9. And I went on to start my own business. I left teaching and I entered the world of entrepreneurship. And I started a mobile gym for kids on an old renovated school bus. And I ran that business in our town of Brentwood for about 9 years. And throughout the course of running that, I developed relationships with people, right? Because that's what this business is about. It's about creating relationships. And I'd like to think I was pretty good at that. So that when 2016 came and I saw Tara talking about the products, I had, like Kai mentioned, suffered some health issues and tried everything to alleviate those issues. And I thought, you know what, why wouldn't I try this all natural product? And so I reached out to Tara at the time and I said, I think I want to try this product you have. And, you know, it didn't take long for me to realize that I wanted to share this product with as many people as I could. I think my mom was the very first person that I even told about doing this, this business. And, you know, it was hard at first. I'm not gonna lie, guys. I was running my business. My boys were 12 and 10 at the time. And, you know, when you run your own business, everything falls on you, right? From website to marketing to payroll, my employees. And I really didn't have time freedom. I didn't. And so when I decided to look at this opportunity of network marketing, and my husband finally got past his preconceived notions when it comes to network marketing, that's when things really started to click, you know, with both of us. And I realized that I could do this and I could still be present for my children. And so that's what I did. And, you know, I hit the rank of Pro 7 in 2 years. and I hit the rank of Pro 8 in 4 years, just this past November. I hit Pro 8, yes, during a global pandemic, when everybody was told to stay home. My team, and I might get emotional here, but my team kicked it up a notch, guys. They did. They kicked it up a notch, and they worked harder than ever to achieve their goals during a global pandemic, which ultimately helped me to achieve my goal, right, of Elite Pro 8, which was just incredible. And I think the work that, you know, my local business partners, Kristen Bailey and Jane Buchanan and I, the work and the team and the culture that we put together over the 4 years of doing this, it's really, that's why I think everything clicked and everything happened. And so, you know, it's so important to pour into your team and to love your team and to be there when they fall, you know, and I think that's a great lesson for everybody, is just to never stop pouring into your team, never stop working hard, never stop showing up. And Kai mentioned events. I'll never forget, my first event was Orlando, Florida. I went by myself because I was of the mindset that I didn't need events, right? I went with my arms folded. You know, I don't need a rah-rah cheerleader event to, you know, to tell me what to do. I was wrong. I realized that first event, sitting down at the table with Christy Vogt and Mary Lee Marisich and Becky Taylor and talking to them and learning from them, and, you know, ultimately emulating them, it's everything. And I have never missed an event since. And I teach my team to never miss an event. You're going to gain so much knowledge when we're in person again, right? So much knowledge. And it's really just going to take your business to the next level. It really is. I want to talk for a minute about quitting. Do me a favor and drop in the chat the number one, if you've ever felt like quitting this business. Okay, drop a one in the chat if that's you. I know when I got my first paycheck, it was $16.50. I looked at my husband and I said, oh boy, this is going to take a long time to even pay for my products, let alone be profitable, right? And he looked at me and he said, you know, you built a business once, you can do it again. And so I actually sold my business when I hit Pro 5, because I knew that I wanted to put the pedal to the metal. I wanted to do this quickly, and I wanted to treat it like a business. I didn't want to treat it like a hobby. And for me, you know, running the business, teaching classes, taking care of my kids, it was too much. I needed to let something go. So I sold my business and I jumped in with both feet to do this. And, you know, I listened to a training from Les Brown the other day where he said, you know, this is not a get rich quick business. It's just not, right? But the job you're working in right now, you could work for the next 20 to 30 years. Are you ever going to make a six-figure income? Some of you might, but many of you probably won't. But that's not going to, you know, you're not going to quit that, right? You're going to keep going. You're going to keep working your job. You know, you're going to keep making your salary. And I think a lot of people get into this business and think it's going to happen overnight. And when it doesn't, right, when they hear the word no, what do? They get their feelings hurt and they quit. Now, I was fortunate when I was starting my business, I heard the word no all the time. So I was used to hearing that and I was ready. You know, every no that I got, I knew was one step closer to a yes, because I'd already been through it, right? So that's a mindset shift that you have to make. And I equate it to real estate agents, right? Real estate agents work so hard in the beginning, staging houses, taking phone calls, doing trainings, showing houses, all in the hopes that they might eventually sell a house. And usually they do, but sometimes they don't. And that doesn't keep them from putting the work in up front. And I think it's really a parallel, you know, profession, real estate and network marketing, because we do so much work. We invest so much into ourselves, not so much monetarily, because it's a very low startup cost, right? But, you know, just the time and the effort to grow your business, it's a lot. And a lot of people just don't have that mindset. And then when it doesn't happen quickly, they give up. So I just want to urge you guys that, you know, at the low points, at the in the dark days, just think of the future and just keep going, because I promise you it's worth it. All right. I want to talk to those of you out there who do work a full-time job, and maybe you're raising kids, maybe you volunteer in your community, and you have zero time to do this, right? And you're asking yourself, can I do this? I'm here to tell you, you can do this, because I did this, right? I had zero time, but that was my why, right? My why was time freedom. I wanted to be in control of my time. When I was an elementary school teacher, I was not in control of my time. I had to show up at a certain time and leave at a certain time. You know, there was mandatory trainings that I had to do, and my paycheck always stayed the same, right? When I was a business owner, I was not in control of my time. If I didn't show up, classes didn't run, and I didn't make money. So with this, I knew, right, that investing in myself and creating that time freedom is what I needed for myself and for my family. And I really, you know, once I realized that this is not, network marketing is not a me game, it's a we game, right? It takes a team to do this. And once I figured that out, and I knew that, you know, it was more than just about me, it was about my team. And I like to share numbers with people, if that's okay. You know, I think it's important for the new people to realize exactly like how many customers I have in 4 years, okay? I have 189 personally enrolled customers over 4 years. Are all 189 still ordering product? No, they're not, but many of them are. And when it comes to distributors, I have 65 personally enrolled distributors. 62, sorry, personally enrolled distributors over the course of a little over 4 years, right? That equates to a little over one a month. And so I want you to realize that it's doable, right? I'm not a person that has 150 distributors personally enrolled to me. Network marketing is a lot of people doing a little bit of work. And once you understand that, and once you consistently pour into people, that's when things will change for you. You know, I'm blessed to have two pro sixes on my team, Katarina Reed and Jane Buchanan. I have Kristen Bailey, who's a pro seven. And I have about 15 pro fives that are knocking on the door to pro six. And so for me, pouring myself into my team, teaching them to follow the system. We have this incredible app that we did not have when I first started. You know, showing up to trainings like this, showing up to Success Saturday trainings that corporate does for us. You know, I think a lot of people might get a little bit overwhelmed with the amount of training, but I tell my team to show up to what you can show up to, right? Whatever you can fit in your schedule, show up to that. Some people want to show up to everything, and that's okay too, but pick and choose, right? What's valuable to you and what's going to help you grow your business. And I gave up in the beginning trying to pull people along with me, right? It was exhausting trying to pull people and to want things for them more than they wanted for themselves. And once I let that go and I really focused on the people that wanted this, that's when things really took off for me, you know, and started to grow. Getting out of management mode was really important. And teaching people to find the answers for themselves, right? I could sit there all day long and answer questions, or I could teach people how to find the answer to the questions and then teach them to teach their people the same, right? And that's important. That's duplication. I talked in the beginning, I used to talk a lot about sacrifice, right? Right now, I'm missing dinner with my family. They're downstairs eating. And I used to say that's a sacrifice, or missing girls' night out, or not watching the newest season of The Bachelor, right? Or going to an event and missing my kids' baseball tournament. I used to say it was a sacrifice. But I've since changed, and it's not a sacrifice. It's an investment, right? It's an investment in me. It's an investment in my team. It's an investment in my business. And ultimately, it's an investment in my family and in our future together. So I think, you know, really taking the negative connotation away from, oh, it's a sacrifice. I'm missing my son's, you know, football game to be here. Uh-uh. It's an investment, and I'm glad to miss out on things so that I can better my life and my family's life. So I think that's really important. Gosh, what else? I know we're going to have a question and answer, and I'm excited for that. So if you have a question, be sure to keep that in your mind. And, you know, I just wanted to thank you guys for having me on tonight. I love sharing my story. Our company has an amazing story. Our product has an amazing story. But I know each and every one of you has an amazing story as well. And I think the important part of this is to keep sharing your story. Keep sharing it authentically. Right? Don't be a billboard on social media, but share your story, share your heart, share the opportunity, share our incredible products, get loud about it, right? Because that's what we're all here for, you guys. It's a once in a lifetime opportunity. And I urge you to not let this opportunity pass you by. So with that, that's all I got for tonight. Thank you so much for having me, Kai.
Wow. Oh my goodness, Angie. What a breath of fresh air you're giving us tonight. How cool is that? I love it. I love your smile. And guess what, you guys? Angie makes it so easy for us because it seemed like she's having fun with this. Like some of you guys, the reason why it gets so frustrating is because kind of like you are burdening yourself so much. I want you, like Angie, you know, to have fun with this. I mean, can you imagine? She said no. And most of the people here, and of course, to my lovely team as well, I noticed that if you receive no's, you're all of a sudden, you're so brokenhearted. And I know we've been there, you know, all of us here, the elites, we've been brokenhearted. We felt what you felt. That's the reason why this training is truly amazing, that it can help you, because we are telling you the truth. We've been there, we've done that. So it truly is. It's very a little bit hurting, but you know what? But it is not no forever. Some of them, well, look at Angie. She's a Pro 8, and she developed 1 Pro 7, 2 Pro 6, and 15 Pro 5s, you guys. So work it, work it, work it, and have fun with this. So I would like to open this up for Q&A. So this is your chance, you guys. So don't be shy. Ask Angie anything that you would like to ask her, any frustrations, any doubts, take it away. Unmute yourself, you guys.
Hi, this is Christy Ann from Boston, Massachusetts. You are phenomenal, Angie. Thank you so much. And Kai, thank you for this opportunity. I would like to ask you a question, Angie. In the beginning of your business, which did you focus on more? Did you focus on kind of going wide, personally sponsoring? Or did you focus more on when you found someone, kind of building down deep in that business? Which way did you go yourself, and what advice would you have?
That's a great question. And really in the beginning, I didn't know what I was doing, and I made mistakes in the beginning, but you know, we build deep, right? I have 6 frontline distributors and I build deep from there. That's how we do it. And I know not everybody does. And I think you have to find kind of what works for you. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Go ahead. Just unmute yourself one by one and one question each for one distributor. Go ahead. Anybody?
Well, that was easy.
Can I go second time, Kai?
Yes, Christian, do you have?
Yes, I have another question, if I may. I wanted to ask you, when you were building your relationships in the beginning of the business with your friends and your family, how did you keep the friends or family who were just customers, how did you keep them interested in wanting to support your business and be a part of it if they weren't distributors?
You know, that's a good question too. And, you know, my mom was actually my very first distributor because I made her. I had all these customers and I think I need a distributor. Again, I didn't really know how to build in the beginning. And I said, Mom, you have to do this. She was retired. She had no interest in doing this, but guess what? My mom's a pro 5 and she works her little booty off. Yeah. She's retired. She's on the call right now and she loves sharing these products with people. And not all of my family and friends though, and I know a lot of you can relate to that. I heard no from my kind of full circle. My very best friend, we've been friends since we were 5 years old, shot me down so hard in the beginning. And I've never talked to her about the products or the business since. And so not all of my friends and family were supportive, but that's okay, right? It didn't stop me. But I also was never that person where you're like, oh God, here she comes. She's gonna talk to me about her products. I really wasn't. Like if we were at Christmas and I had a family member ask me, I in the beginning would actually change the subject. I would. I just wasn't even comfortable talking to my friends and family about it. And it kind of worked in a way because some of them were like, what? I want to know what you're doing. What is this? And, you know, and some of them did join me. My brother's a distributor. He's a pro 4, but took him 2 years to come around. And I just think, you know, just don't stop sharing authentically. Don't let it dull your fire. Keep doing what you know you're meant to do. And people will come around. It might take them 2 years. It might take them 4 years. It might take them 10 years, but eventually they will come around.
Oh, thank you. That was very encouraging and very valuable and very real. I appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah,
absolutely.
Hi, Angie. This is Emmy.
Oh my God.
I just want to ask you, what is your daily method of operation? Because we heard all our elite friends, our team, and we learn from them, but maybe there's something because you're really calm and very composed. And you had been a full-time worker, so we can relate, some of us, but there's really,
can I get my husband up here so he can hear you say I'm calm and composed?
Okay, if you can share your daily method of operation. I mean, first of all, we are really inspired by your story, and you're so calm and very composed, and you make it sound like, oh my God, I can really do this. So, and you had a full-time job before, so right. If you can share it.
So I'll share my daily method of operation when I was a full-time, you know, business owner and mom to two younger boys who needed me a lot more at the time. My boys now are 14 and 16, so they're a little bit more self-sufficient. But, you know, in the beginning, I would carve out 10-minute chunks of my day. I would get up early before my kids. And, you know, the amazing thing about this business, you guys, is this is what you need right here, right? I would sit in the pickup loop at school waiting for my kids and I would be working. I would sit at baseball practice and while all the other moms, you know, were talking or walking, I would be working because that's what I had to do, right? I didn't want to miss out on family time. I didn't watch a lot of TV in the beginning, that's for sure, because I wanted to build my business. Now it's a little bit different because I do it full time. But my DMO now, I always, every single day start with mindset, right? I think mindset training is huge no matter where you are in this company. I'm always plugging into the calls. I'm always listening. I'm really big on Audible. You know, I'll be cooking dinner, walking my dog, you know, driving in the car, and I will be listening to some sort of a book or a podcast always, because that is a good use of my time. I even quit the gym because I didn't want to spend an hour exercising and not being able to listen to mindset training. So now I'm able to do that outside or in my house. I have an elliptical and I'm able to kind of kill two birds with one stone. So always do that. You know, the app, I can't stress enough how important it is to plug into the app. They walk you through step by step how to do this business. And again, we didn't have that at the beginning. I had no network marketing experience, so I didn't really know what I was doing in the beginning. I definitely made some mistakes, you know, but I looked at the leaders and I just, you know, I followed what they told me to do. I didn't try to reinvent the wheel, which I think a lot of people, especially business owners, come in and think, oh, I can do this better. You can't. right? Just follow the system, do what your leaders tell you to do, show up to the calls, show up to the trainings, show up to the events, and stay consistent with doing it every single day, not all day, right? But every single day, even when Kai and I were in Ireland, I know both of us were still working, right? And that's the beauty of this business, is you can work in little chunks of the day.
Wow. Thank you so much. You really inspired us.
Hi.
Next.
Hi, Angie.
Can you hear me? Yes.
Hi. Thank you so much for tonight. It's so inspiring and makes me think that I can do it. Because I'm a full-time worker as well. And the part-time that I do the business, it's really a discipline issue. To focus on the things that I have to do for the business. So usually my problem is being stuck with the database. Like, have you ever felt that I'm losing, I don't have enough database. And so—
You mean enough prospects?
Enough prospects.
No, I really don't. You know, I had this conversation the other day with one of my distributors. I don't like hearing, I've already talked to everybody. You have not talked to everybody, right? I mean, I'm 4 years into this and I'm not even a fraction of the way through my warm market. I know a lot of people build online and that's amazing. That's not me yet. I've never enrolled a distributor to this day that I didn't have some sort of a relationship with before. Now, I know a lot of people do build that way and that's amazing, but you know, my team, and I think that's why we have such a strong team culture, is that, you know, we're connected to people, right? It's not just somebody through the screen. So when somebody tells me I've ran out of people, I say, then you need to get out more, right? And it's kind of hard during the pandemic, but you're meeting people at Starbucks, at the grocery store. I joined a local networking group here. You know, I've joined the chamber. There are people everywhere. You're never, ever, ever going to run out of people to talk to. You're not. So, you know, in referrals, right? You know, everybody you talk to, yeah, they might say no to you. Great. Who do you know that might be interested in, right?
Yeah, I asked that. Thank you so much.
Yeah, sure.
Hello.
Hi.
Go ahead, Ricky.
Hello. This is Ricky. I'm from Odessa.
Hi, Ricky.
Hey, yeah. How do you keep your people motivated, especially now there's COVID, right? Because I was just interested when you told them, you told us a while ago that they were motivated when COVID came. So how did you do that?
Well, I think the work that, you know, like I said, Kristen and Jane and I, we did that work before COVID, right? It all comes down to relationships and wanting to be there to lift each other up and to support each other. How do I motivate people? By doing the do, right? Doing the work. I don't feel like my job is to really motivate my team, right? Mm-hmm. I'm looking for people that are self-motivated, right? Mm-hmm. I'm looking for people that I don't have to call and say, it's our Monday night call. Are you going to be on tonight? I'm looking for the people that want more and more and more and more. And those are the people that are going to succeed. And that's not everybody. It's not. But I just think, you know, leading by example, exactly, you know, showing up, being excited, knowing what we have our hands on, sharing my story, right? I share my story with anybody that'll listen. I really do. And I think just, you know, having my team, you know, watch me do that, I would hope motivates them. I don't know. Some of them are on today. Maybe they can drop that in the chat, but I hope I motivate them. But again, I think motivation comes from within.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mm-hmm. On to the last question, you guys. Going before we wrap up this call, one more question for you. If not, I'm going to ask one last question for you, Angie, because we have a lot of new distributors that are here tonight. And so therefore, I kind of like, you know, we elites here, the Think Like a Pro elite leaders, we wish to impose to our new distributors that, you know, inviting, you know, the ITT system is really practiced and really followed on. So in order for them to establish that habit from the get-go, so ITT or invite, when they are new, within 90 days, they're set. We need to set them up for success, right? So can you tell them, so that they can hear it from you, not from us, can you tell them that how important it is to just bring the people to us? And they cannot talk too much from the very beginning. Instead, bring the people to us and listen to what we have to say to their prospects. Can you expound on that, Angie, right? How important that is?
I think what happens with a lot of people is that they feel like they have to know it all. They have to know the science. They have to know the studies. They have to know the company's story, you know, and they don't have all the answers, right? Because it's complicated. It is. It's complicated to explain in the beginning. I remember when I first heard the ingredients of NRF2, I'm like, I'm never going to remember that, right? Well, now I can spit it off like anything, right? And I know our products, but it took time. So I think in the beginning, knowing you're not the tool, right? Use your leaders. They've been here. They've done it. That's where third-party validation comes in and is crucial. It's crucial in the beginning, guys, because if you're out there, you know, talking about things that you don't really know about, what's going to happen, right, is your friends and family are going to say, well, what is this? This sounds really weird. And they're not going to have, you know, trust and confidence in you. So your job is to get the people to the information and let the leaders, let your enroller, you know, do the work from there until you're ready. So I think that's where a lot of people just get scared and they stop, or they maybe do the wrong thing. I know, you know, there's nothing like posting a big long post on Facebook and thinking, oh, wow, I'm gonna have so many people like it. And then it's crickets, right? And what happens? You feel like a failure. But here's the thing. They're watching. I still hear from people that go, oh, yeah, I saw you've never commented on one thing I've ever posted, but they're watching, right? So stay consistent, stay authentic, don't be a billboard. I like to practice attraction marketing for sure. And then, you know, I still use third party validation to this day. So I think it's really important.
Wow. Guys, I hope you are taking lots of notes from Angie's words of wisdom, you guys. Yes, definitely. Yes, yes. And why don't you please type in the word hugs on the comment section below? Because we need to send Angie some loving care, tender loving care. Just type in hugs on your comment section below. And Angie, what a great time with you today, my dear. And
thank you, so much,
thank you, by the way, for saying yes to my invitation and gracing our show. And we are so fortunate here tonight. And along with your team, thank you so much for joining us. This is such a wonderful training tonight. We love you all, you guys. Thank you for joining us here. And I love you, Angie.
Thank you. I love you, Kai. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Brandy, thank you. Debbie Crown and Dr. Jean, I know you're here. Thank you so much. Christine, I see.